Let's bow our hearts and heard in prayer. Lord, we thank this wonderful opportunity that you have given to us so we can come into your presence and experience the matchless love and the unending grace that you've given us. Lord, as we're going to sing and worship your name, Lord, we ask for your presence to come and fill this place. Let the glory of God fill this place. Let the glory of God fill every devices, every platform on which this worship, this session of worship and word is going to be streamed. We pray for the complete blessing of this service. May the Holy Spirit take over the control of this meeting from the beginning till to its end. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Praise. I will bring praise. I will bring praise because no weapon that is formed against me will prosper. Amen. I will rejoice and I will declare because God is my victory and He is here today. Amen. How many of you believe that God is here in our midst? Because His word promises us that if only two or three are gathered in His name, that He will be here in our midst. What an honor is it for us to have the presence of God Almighty here in our midst. Amen. No weapon that is formed against me shall remain. When so many over the past year has been affected by the pandemic, when so many has been affected by the virus and various diseases and various circumstances, God has protected us. God has covered us under His mighty wings. Amen. So it should be no surprise for us that we are here and that we are singing out to God and that we are just praising Him and worshiping Him and just telling Him that, God, we praise You because I know that no weapon that is formed against me will remain, that I know that You are with me and that You are here. Amen. So God deserves all of our praise and He deserves all of our worship, because if it wasn't for Him, we would not have come into this new year. Amen. There were so many people who might have plans and who might have had so many things in store for them for 2021, but it was us that God chose to see this new year. Amen. So let's just sing that chorus one more time and let's just give God all the praise that He deserves. Come on, church, let's just stand up, let's rise up to our feet and just put your hands together and worship Him.
I will bring praise, no weapon formed against me shall remain. I will rejoice, I will declare, God is my victory and He is here.
I will bring praise,
I will bring praise.
Come on, church, just sing that out loud and just declare that.
I will rejoice,
I will declare, God is my victory.
Just declare that.
I will bring praise.
No weapon formed against me shall remain.
Don't be shy to just be yourself in the presence of God. Just go crazy for Him.
I will bring praise.
No weapon formed against me shall remain. I will rejoice.
I will declare.
God is my victory.
What an honor it is for us to praise and worship Him, right? So many times in life, what happens to us is that we allow ourselves to be defined by our circumstances, or we allow ourselves to be defined by the people around us, right? Many times we find our worth in how much the people around us love us. We find our worth in how much those around us accept us. And we are often faced with disappointment because we are not being loved, or we are not being accepted the way we want to be loved, that the way we want to be accepted, right? And we allow that to define us. We allow those things to define us, and we tell ourselves, you know what, maybe I'm not good enough. You know what, maybe I'm not that lovable of a person. I'm not good enough for people to love me, for people to accept me. And somehow within us, there develops this spirit of loneliness, that develops the spirit of orphan, where we feel like we have nobody, where we feel like we don't belong anywhere, right? I don't know if this is speaking to anyone right now, but maybe you're feeling really alone and you're feeling like, I don't belong anywhere. Where is my place in this world? But I just want to remind you today that you are so precious in the eyes of God, because you are the apple of God's eye, and Just imagine that God Almighty, He puts so much of time and detail into creating who you are, because you are so fearfully and wonderfully made in the eyes of God. Amen. And you are not alone, and you are not unwanted, because God so loved you that He gave His only begotten Son to die for you. Amen. So that you can know that you have been bought at the price of the most precious thing that is to God, that is His Son. You know why God did that? So that you and I can be called children of God. Amen. We are no longer slaves. We are no longer abandoned. We are no longer orphans. Amen. But we are the child of God. I just want you to sing in assurance and know in assurance that God has called you child. God has called you son. God has called you daughter. You are not alone. Whatever lies that the enemy is speaking to you right now, we break that in the name of Jesus. Come on, church, let's just pray and let's just break off those chains that are holding us, because you are Son of God. You are the daughter of God. Just put your hand on your chest and just declare that I am the daughter of God. I am the daughter of God. Say your name and say Mahima. Mahima is the daughter of God. Mahima is loved by God. It is for Mahima that Jesus came down on this earth and died on the cross, so that I, Mahima, will be called the daughter of Christ, the daughter of God. Amen. You are not alone. You are loved by God. You are so loved by God, and you are chosen by God. That just understand the sacrifice that God made so that you and I can be brought at a price, and that we can go into His throne room of grace and cry out, Abba Father. Amen. As we sing this song, I just want you to know that you are no longer a slave to fear, and that you are a child of God, and that God right now is looking at you with so much love in His eyes, with so much love in His heart, and God is dancing over you and singing songs of joy over you. Amen. So just sing this song with us and just know that you belong to Him. No matter who leaves you, no matter who abandons you, God is choosing you today. Amen.
Yeah.
city so I could walk right through it. My fears are drowned in perfect love. You rescued me and I will stand and sing. I am a child of God. So I could walk right through it. My fears are drowned in perfect love. You rescued me and I will stand and sing. I am a child.
What they really are a chosen nation of God, the very chosen people of God. Amen. But the enemy took them away. The enemy dragged them away from what belonged to them. And he put them in bondage. He put them in slavery where they were never meant to be. Amen. But God sent Moses to save the Israelites and to bring them into the promised land. Amen. So in the same way, we were in this world, in bondage to sin, in slavery to all of the desires of this world, in slavery to all of the lust of this world. Amen. But God sent His Son, God sent Jesus to drag us away, to break us away from what is in this world, to bring us into our promised land that is heaven. Amen. Egypt was never meant for the Israelites. Just like that, this world and all of the belongings of this world was never meant for us. We are called to be in a higher place. Amen. So God, I just want to encourage you, and I just want you to know that God will do anything. God will do anything. He split the sea. Amen. He tore whatever was keeping the Israelites away from what was meant for them. Amen. God split the sea for the Israelites. In the same way, I feel like this is what the Spirit of the Lord is speaking to me, and He wants me to tell you this. God is breaking barriers. Whatever it is, God is just breaking barriers so that you can reach out to Him. What are you so scared of? Do you feel like you won't be loved enough? Do you feel that God is not going to accept you in the situation that you are in? Do you feel like God is not going to accept you as you are? But let me just tell you, in the name of Jesus, that God is breaking some barriers in this place. Come on, church, let's just worship Him. Come on, church, just speak in tongues and just worship Him. Because today God is breaking some barriers. Whatever is holding you back, if it was someone that hurt you, God is healing that hurt in the name of Jesus so that you can experience the fullness of God's love in your life. Amen. Come on, church, just keep worshiping. we ask your love to just flood this place. To do all of the broken pieces in you, all of the parts of you that you are so ashamed to show to the rest of the world, the Spirit of the Lord is looking directly at that. He's looking at that mess in you. He's looking at that brokenness in you, and he's looking right at it, and he wants to fill that emptiness. He wants to fill that brokenness with his divine love. Church, just surrender yourselves to him and allow him to love you the way you deserve to be loved. Not in the way that man would love you, but in a way only God can love you. Just remain surrendered to him, because, you know, God doesn't love us because he has to. God doesn't love us just because we are his creation. God loves us because he wants to. Amen? I don't know why, but I feel like God is speaking very in particular to one person sitting here on my left. I think you know that God is speaking to you. I don't want to point fingers. I don't want to call names. But God is speaking directly to you, and you know it. Allow God to love you the way he wants to love you. Allow the love of God to fill you, because your life is just never going to be the same. Whatever is broken inside of you, whatever trauma is there inside of you, whatever is unhealed inside of you is going to be washed away in the blood, in the love of Jesus. Allow the love of God to flood you. Allow the love of God to just fill you up. Because he is your father, and he's calling you home. He's calling you to him. It's not just on what's on the outside. God doesn't care about what's on the outside. He cares about what's on the inside. You know, the psalmist David, he was rejected by everybody. He was rejected by his own father. He was rejected by his own brothers. He was rejected by his own mother. But God chose him. When the prophet Samuel, such a mighty prophet of God, when he walked into the town trembled and they were in fear, and they asked him, "Man of God, what do you want with us? Why are you here?" Samuel had heard the voice of God that said, go, go choose David, go anoint David, go bless David. And where was David? He was out in the wilderness where no one can see him, where no one wanted him. He was ashamed to his family. So they'd rather that he be in a place where no one can associate him with the family of Jesse. But with the whole town standing, with the whole town standing in watch, Prophet Samuel said, we will not sit to feast until David is brought. Amen. And that's what God is speaking to you right now. To whoever is listening to me, that's what God is speaking to you. You may have been pushed aside. You may have been rejected. But today God is telling you, until he or she comes, we are not going to feast. So until you decide to surrender, until you decide to give God all of you, God is not going to move in the way that we expect him to move. So surrender. So give yourself to him, because there is going to be a feast in this place, because heaven is waiting to come down just for you. God is waiting just for you. Heaven is waiting just for you. So if you surrender and if you can come to him with abandoning everything that is holding you back, we are going to be feasting on the presence of God today. We are going to be feasting on the love of God today. Amen. And if that is something that you really want, don't worry. Don't worry about what anybody is going to think. Don't worry about what the outcome of this is going to be. But if you really want to experience and feast on the divine love of God, just surrender. Just stand abandoned in his presence, because heaven's love is going to fill you up. God's divine love is going to fill you up. And that's what you really need right now. Amen. So let's just lift up our hands and stand in complete surrender and in complete abandon. And let's just sing, Lord, I stand in awe of you. Lord, I stand in awe of who you are. Lord, I stand in awe of what you want to do in my life. I stand completely surrendered. I stand completely abandoned. Come on, just raise your hand as a faith action. Just raise your hand. Lift your hands up to heaven in faith action, knowing that God is going to fill you up. Amen? Lord, I just pray, Father God, that this is your promise, that you spoke your words right now, Lord, that you want us to feast on heaven, that you want us to feast on your divine love. So Lord, I just pray that you fill this place up with your divine love, Father God, that all the brokenness would be filled up, Father God, that all of that is in pain, Father God, will be healed through your love, Father God. Lord, let your divine love just fill this place, Father God. Lord, touch your children, Father God. Speak to your children, Father God. Move in this place, Father God. Let us experience your presence like never before, Father God. Just fill this place with your love, Father God, because we need you and we are nothing without you.
Surrender.
for them? Can I please ask the pastors? Can I please ask the leadership to just lay hands and pray for the people that are here right now? And those watching us online, you don't need pastors to lay hands on you. You can just lay your hand on yourself and just pray. And say, God, I want you to touch me. Lord, I want to experience that heavenly love. I want to experience that peace inside of me. So much for your presence in this place, and we thank you for moving, and we thank you for speaking to our hearts. Lord, thank you for mending whatever is broken. Thank you for making whole whatever is broken, Father God. Thank you for healing the pain inside of us, and thank you for reinstating, Father God, the truth that we are chosen and loved by you, and that we are your children, that we are your sons and daughters, that we were bought at the price of Jesus being crucified on the cross, that we were bought at the price of Jesus' precious blood. And there is nothing that can take us away from your love. Holy Spirit, I ask you to continue ministering to our hearts, to continue rooting that truth that we are His in our hearts. Lord, we as a church banish every lie of the devil in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of abandonment, every spirit of orphan, every spirit of loneliness in the name of Jesus. We belong to you. We are yours. And we are so deeply loved by you. And we thank you so much for ministering to our hearts. Lord, I submit all of our members who are present here and all of our members watching us online. Bless them. Continue ministering to them. Lord, we submit your servant into your hands. Use him. Speak mightily through him. Let him be a mighty weapon in your hand today. Let your word be so powerfully spoken through him. Thank you for everything that you have done in our lives, and that you are doing in our lives, and all that you are going to do in our lives, Lord. We thank you so much. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.